And back here for the start of half number two, Gonzaga has a one-point lead on Winter Park. Spalding Hoophall Classic here at the Blake Arena in Springfield. Chris Villani and Ben Larson along with you for game number four of five today, day number two. And even though Gonzaga has the lead, that young man, Austin Rivers, has been the story here in the first half with some electric plays, including a couple of big slam dunks. We'll take a look at them. This one-handed slam over the taller defender, able to get to the baseline and score a couple of times. And he just has such a great ability, Ben, to get inside, to penetrate, and there you see the big finish in the alley-oop.
He does. It's just his body control as well. Just, you know, he's in the air, flying through the air, very athletic, can maneuver himself even after he leaves his feet. And we'll look at the one-on-one matchup with Duke-bound Tyler Thornton of Gonzaga. Austin Rivers certainly winning at this point, 10 points to Tyler's 5, and Austin has kind of made things tough on Thornton as well.
And it's nothing but a family thing for Austin Rivers. Comes from those great bloodlines. Of course, the son of head coach Doc Rivers of the Boston Celtics, Jeremiah Rivers, his older brother, who played at Georgetown, now the starting point guard at Indiana. And there is Doc Rivers watching his younger son play. His daughter, the sister of Jeremiah and Austin, Callie Rivers, is also a collegiate volleyball player at Florida. Very athletic family, and Austin Rivers has plenty of those athletic genes. We're back underway. Rivers misses a three, and Gonzaga brings it back on offense. And for all the excitement that Austin Rivers has brought, his team still trails. Gonzaga has played very well.